Good afternoon, it's Natalie again with Risen Legacy. I am fixing to do a couple swatches for you guys. I'm going to use, this time, I wanted to use spring colors still. I'm going to give some of you time to join, so I'm just kind of chit-chatting. But I just did a swatch using Tickle Me Pink, Cotton Candy, and Raspberry Sherbet. These are beautiful colors. I am still going to add the top coat and then post a picture for you. Today, on this video, I'm gonna use Pretty in Pink, Bubblegum, and Princess. Now, these are all light shades of pink. They're very pretty. They're gonna be very pretty for summer when you ladies have a dark tan. These are gonna be super bright. Right now, they're really pretty for spring break, for spring coming up, and then some of them are pretty pastels for Easter. So I thought that I would do a couple swatches of those so you can kind of see the different pinks in each color. Hello, whoever's on, say hey for me so I'll know who I'm chit-chatting with. Sorry, I ended the other video and then I started this one, but I just don't want it to be super long, and I'm kind of trying to separate them because I'm going to put them on YouTube as well, our Risen Legacy YouTube. So if you guys have not subscribed to that yet, please do, after this video, go to it and subscribe so you will get all the upcoming notifications for all my new videos that I'm putting up constantly. I'm continually putting up new ones. I've got a couple to add of exactly what I mean by capping, and when I say remember to cap all edges and sides, I have a video explaining exactly what I mean by that. There's another video I did, one of infilling. It is very difficult to do that with using dips, but if you have a hand drill like I do, it's easy to file down the part that has grown out. Hey, Audra, and Chelsea, hey, happy leap day, yes. Oh, which reminds me of my grandmother, it's her birthday today, so happy birthday in heaven. But I did a video of where you can infill the dipping. I will post it. I also, during that video, used what you call, oh shucks. My mind went blank. What are these called? I cannot think of what these are called. I will tell you later. But I did some of the... I did a couple of designs from these on my nails with that video. So I will get that posted soon. like I said, it's very difficult when dipping to infill them. But if you do have a hand drill, you can file off and kind of file down. And then you just do your same process as far as putting the base coat on, dipping. You don't have to do all the Pure Diamond Clear layers because you already have that layer there. Again, I do that first layer of clear to build the apex, but also if you're like me, nail stamps. Audra, thank you so much. I don't know why I had a little brain bump and could not think of that. So yes, nail stamp. This is stamping. It's pretty cool. We do not have these yet. We are in process of probably getting them. I am testing a bunch of them to see which ones I like, how they do, if it is something that will sell that you guys would love. So that's something I'm doing. And we're also, just so you guys know what's coming up and available, we are going to come out with those pigments. Your rose gold. Ooh, that sounded country. Sorry. Your rose gold color pigments. And then we've got our mirrored chrome pigment. So we are in process of testing some matte top coats, some real shiny top coats that you cure with a light. And so when those become available, I will get out the mirror chrome. Guys, I have the prettiest colors. That I'm not sure if you're aware of that, but you put it on with, you can use your finger or you can use, most people normally use like your eyeshadow brush, sponge brush, and apply that. It just gives you that super shiny like mirror look. It's totally awesome. And the silver that I do have is actually shaved shard pure silver. So it shines like crazy. I will have to just show you a demo. But it is something that is going to come out. It just may take just a little bit of time. And then I'm working on nail flakes, those foils that are so cool. And so we just came out with our accent glitters. Don't forget that. So with every purchase you purchase for a limited time, I have not set a close date for that just yet, but for a limited time, you will get an accent glitter. I will pair up whatever looks good with the color that you have chosen to purchase. So I will give you one of those. Those are really cool. There's a video up on YouTube of that, of how to use it. So check that out. Let's get started. I'm going to turn the camera around and I'm going to use monomer today. On this video, I'm going to use bubblegum, princess, and pretty in pink. So I want you to be able to see all of these pinks lined up. Let me turn this around for you and put it in a different thing. All right. So here is Risen Legacy's monomer. I have already labeled these, so when you ladies are watching me do this, you can see what colors I'm using. I hope the lighting is better. I did adjust all that during my break. I'm going to start with Pretty in Pink. Hey, Veronica. Thank you for tagging others. Guys, y'all, if you are enjoying this and want to share it after, please do tag Risen Legacy. It's at risen.legacy, I believe. Tag us and let all your friends know we're out there. We are a newer company, ladies, but I have been testing this entire past year, finding the very best products that go together, that give you the most strength and durability. I've taken into consideration all the drying times and stuff like that. All of our acrylics are custom made. I actually mix them all myself. Nobody can copy my colors. It's a very fine ratio that you distinguish between when mixing. And so I kind of wanted something original, something that nobody can copy. I had somebody ask me if we are planning, if we actually custom color like request. We don't do that yet. That is something I do eventually plan on getting on the website. I want to get this company up and going big before we invest in so many things. There are so many things out there. I eventually want to get the curing lights and brushes for you ladies to do the monomer with and stuff like that. But it's something I've got to work my way into, but I have so many plans once we get going and get everything together like we want it to all be. But as far as the products, I wanted to get it out here and available to y'all because I don't know if you saw an ad I did. I have done the math, y'all, and once you get the Pro Kit has everything you need in it to do a set. Once you get the Pro Kit and stuff, y'all, it is like right under $3 to do your nails with Risen Legacy's products every time you do them. So every 2 weeks, going to the salon for dipping is roughly, gosh, they all charge different depending on where you stay, but roughly around $45 to $50. If you do that every 2 weeks, it's a little over $1,200 a year. So I did mine, adding it up with the Pro Kit and just a couple more colors, like if you were to buy extra colors, and it's a little under $3 every time you go to do a set of your nails. So if you've got little ones, that love their nails done, or kids in high school, stuff like that. This is such a great buy, y'all. It is the exact same thing they are using in the salons. I promise you, I have tested my products with the top of the line name brands. I'm not sure that I'm supposed to mention them, but if you are into dipping or anything like that, you know that there's SNS, Kierskai, Revel, there's a lot of different companies like that, but I want to assure you guys that I have tested mine with every one of those, and it withholds just the same, if not better, than theirs do. My top coat, my air dry top coat, oh my goodness, I have tested to nauseam, but it is by far the best, and it is actually the shiniest out of all of them that I have tried. The main thing to know is that your liquids need to be room temperature, at least 68 degrees or a little bit warmer. Glass is such a big insulator, so if like out here we keep everything cooler. I'm gonna go in with bubble gum now. So that the products stay better, longer, and fresher. So everything's a little bit colder. So I have to make sure that I take some of my liquids inside and have them warm when I go to use them. It assures that the top coat will dry at the speed it's supposed to. Now I'm going in with bubble gum. I got my first bead. Pretty in Pink is very similar to Pink Agate that was in that Valentine's Day special. It's not as bright. So this is bubblegum. My sister did a video using bubblegum. This is her favorite color. Me doing these makes me want to soak mine off and start over. I want summer here so bad. This cold weather just not working for me. But this is bubblegum. Does anybody have any questions? Hey, Courtney. I was expecting a couple other people on here that I don't see on here yet. Y'all say hey so I know who's watching. I would love to know who's watching. I am using monomer today. Because with these three swatches, it's a little difficult to dip. But it's kind of all the same, so that is bubblegum. It is a really pretty pastel pink look. Then we're gonna go to Princess. Hey, Courtney! I like your little emoji. Remember, if the comments and stuff are in the way, y'all swipe right and that will go away so you can see what I'm doing down low. If I get out of focus, y'all let me know, because I kind of have the thing that's holding my phone is really blocking my view, so I can just barely see like the lower comments that you guys are writing me. So let's see. Is this one of my brushes? This is just a brush that I use that I have for now. I will be getting some that are very similar to this because I do like it. This is a number, a size 8. It's just one that I grabbed off Amazon. If you're needing one now, you want to make sure that you're using Kolinsky, Red Sable brush hairs. That's the best. So, and then this is a size 8. Hey, Tammy. This is Princess I'm going in with, named after my little bitty girl. Kenny, they were in here. I had to make them leave. It is so cute how y'all that have little girls, they see me doing these videos in here, and it's so funny because I'll take a break in here from during the day of filling orders and doing stuff, and like on a Saturday when they're not at school, I'll go in there and they're inside with their iPads making videos on their, well, theirs is how to make slime. So actually my husband told them we would create a YouTube channel for them today because they want to do what mommy does. And I think it's so cute how they just imitate stuff like that. But they're in there teaching kids to how to make slime. And for my oldest birthday last week, all she wanted was slime stuff. So I bought her 2 gallons of that clear paint and got her, oh my goodness, I got her some kits off of Amazon with diamonds and beads and balls and unicorns and stuff like that you mix in with it. What did they call it? Now they're mixing clay with slime, and it's called, what's it called? Shoot, I can't think of it. Y'all, I have brain farts when I get on this live video. I'm so sorry. So, our monomer, so you guys know, is, I told it in the last video, but it does have the UV inhibitors in it, so it is like the solar nail stuff. It's not going to turn yellow when you tan or you're out in the sun and stuff, so that is good to know. Let me show y'all. Let's see if this is focused. Let's see here. Right here, we've got Pretty in Pink. I'm going to let them dry just a little bit longer, and then I'll put a clear coat on for you guys to see. But Pretty in Pink, and then we have Bubblegum, which is more of a pinky, pink. And then Princess. Are those coming in for y'all to see? Butter slime. Tanny, is butter slime with the clay? I can't Google it, or I would. Not clay slime. Slime... I don't know, girl. Anyways, they're having fun with that, and I bought them a ton of, like, food dye, so they're making it all different colors and stuff, but I have Ziploc upon Ziploc upon Ziploc. I'm like, maybe you should take that to school for show and tell and then pass it all out. Anyways, these are these 3 colors. Let me add a top coat to the top 2 that are dry, and we'll let the bottom dry. Clay and slime is butter slime. Okay. Oh, mine are also, my husband just threw it in there, but it's, he threw in shave cream. So it makes it smell good, and it just makes it extremely fluffy. It's really, really cool. So if you want to try that, I'm looking for my top coat, y'all. I'm so sorry. Here it is. Since it's smooth as butter. Okay. Butter slime. Got it. Got it, Tammy. Thank you. Now, with monomer, the more it dries, you can shape. That's called a C-curve. You can actually go in, and this one's not dry enough yet, but you can actually go in and squeeze. They also make a C-curve tool that's called a pincher. I don't want to mess up that bottom one, but essentially you go in, once you put it on and it's dry enough, you can go in. This is if you're not using tips and you are making, you're actually forming your own tips. You would use that C-clamp and that pincher and give it that natural curve look. So let me go in with this top coat and show y'all the shine on these. I need to do an ombre one for y'all. Who would like that? Sculptures. Audra, you're awesome. Sculptured tips. I don't know why. I am going blank. I need more coffee. I took a Benadryl last night because we're all so stopped up. Do y'all have any questions or any colors that you're wanting to see? Right now, I'm just throwing together some colors so that you can see. Sorry, I have a Band-Aid. He got a new knife from Pampered Chef, and I straight up almost sliced my finger off, and I cannot get it to quit bleeding, so I have to wear a Band-Aid. But anyways, I think I'm going to do... I don't know. Do y'all want to see an ombre? I can do some purples. I've got tons of things I can do. I just want to know what y'all want to see. That's what's important. On mine is, I have been working with them today, so they're not shiny. I've got some monomer and everything on them. So I've got Plum Dandy on, and then my party nail is Sunkissed. And then I did the stamping with the gold nail polish. And so that's what's on mine. But I've totally messed them up. That's why I do mine every day or every other day. I'm always jacking with my nails. So here is... Let's see here. I'm trying to get it to zoom. There we go. Pretty in Pink is a really pretty pink color. Bubblegum is more of a, the name of the color, Bubblegum. It's a pinkish pink. And then Princess is very similar. It's just a slight bit darker. Can y'all see that? Let me go ahead and put, it's probably dry enough for me to put a... And then there is Princess. There we go. So those are really, really pretty. I will post a final picture of these on the website. And again, these videos will go up on Risen Legacy's YouTube. So... y'all watch out for those. Like and subscribe so you get notifications. Share. That would be amazing if you guys would share constantly for me to help me get Risen Legacy out there. There's lots of little companies, so not a lot of people know about Risen Legacy yet, but it will be huge once it gets out there, ladies. So if y'all can help me share that would be great. Here's these colors. Again, here's the swatch I did before. Let me name them for you. Are they coming in? Let me see here. Let's see. Okay, so we've got... Tickle Me Pink is this one. Cotton Candy, again, has the beautiful shimmer in it. And then this one is Raspberry Sherbet. Then you've got Pretty in Pink, Bubblegum, and Princess. So there's those so far. I will label these for you ladies to see. And then I'm going to go ahead and pick out a couple more pretty pinks. So we can kind of have all these set up and I can show you an end result picture of these. So I'm going to hop off here quickly and then start a new live with some new colors. So... thank you guys for watching. Share and subscribe. Love y'all. Bye-bye.